鸡蛋。
你是每天都要有人直播吗？没有，一个礼拜三天，一人一天。 Give me a sec. We are almost ready to go. Just setting up my live stream on Facebook. Hold on, 10.
You
start. Hello everybody, just bear with me for 1 minute. I'm very new to this, all these technical stuff. Hello? Where do I look? Hang on. Can you all hear me? Hello, hello. Okay, I'm a bit nervous. I felt there was like 10,000 eyes on me. Sounds like you were in the shower. Really? Hang on. You can hear me? Yes? Me sound perfect? Yep. And video is okay, audio is okay. Are we ready to go? Okay. I'm just asking my assistant / my husband to come over, sit in front of the screen and watch what's happening with you guys. I can hear you, this black squiggly lines. That's because my studio has this LED light. It just doesn't, those lines, it's unavoidable anyway. Just rushed my dinner. I was hungry, too hungry. Been in my studio for a full day. Okay. And maybe I'll just turn on this light so that it's not. Can you see how the screen is blinking? Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, there's nothing I can do about it. It's due to the light from my ceiling. Let me bring. We haven't seen my face yet. Here we go. That is me. Somehow there's a delay on the screen. Why is it not showing my face? Oh, there's a delay. Never mind. Okay, forget about my face. You don't want to see my face. Okay, so we can see everything. Yep, I've got this baby model here. Put my headphone on. See those comments. If there's anything critical, let me know, okay? Yeah.
Okay.
Anything critical, let me know. Otherwise, we shall get started. Actually, I haven't got my luck yet. I'll be back in one sec. Okay, I'm back. I've got my baby here on my lap. What I'm going to do now is let me talk about. It's just so many things, a million things are over my head. So I need to clear my mind a little bit. Sorry, guys. Make sure you can see and make sure you can hear. Good. Let's go ahead. Okay. My agenda today is to cover what I'm going to use, what I use. Can you pass me my camera? What I usually use in terms of my gears for my newborn sessions. As you already know, I am a both natural light and studio light newborn photographer. I use Einstein's 640, which is the one just in front of me. I'm gonna show you in a minute. And I use natural light as well. So strobe, this is Einstein, and I also use Jinbei constant light 200 watt for my client's in-home photo shoot. So sorry I'm confusing you a bit. For the studio strobe I use Einstein 640 for in-home photo shoot. When I go to client's home, I sometimes use the natural light, sometimes I use constant light, just depending on the circumstances. It's a hard word. So that's regarding the light. You'll see how my light is in here. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's Einstein 640, and I've got a 1.8 meters umbrella. A lot of people know this as 1.8 PLM, but it's not made by Paul Bath PLM, it's made by Jinbei. It's the same thing, umbrella. So you can see the umbrella has a pole in here, and it's an umbrella. So once it fires, once strobe fires, it goes in. See how the light's going? I don't know if you can see. But anyway, it's an umbrella. It's not a softbox. This is what I use for my lights, my umbrella. If I go to my client home, I obviously can't bring such a big umbrella. If I don't use natural light, I use constant light. I also use a diffuser, it's a smaller version of an umbrella. It's only 1.2 meters. The reason why I bring constant light rather than using 100% natural light is because if you travel, you know, sometimes it's cloudy day and sometimes you get your clients all kind of lighting situations, or maybe they have a tinted glass, which is very tricky and challenging for us to add it later on. So I'd rather have them. Or maybe the apartment is too small for using natural light. Any kind of reasons. So rather than fiddling with natural light, I use constant light. And also because where I'm coming from, as a Chinese, a lot of parents are concerned about the strobe. If I take the strobe with me, I may end up not being able to use at all because they have grandparents. Rather than having all sorts of issues and troubles, after a while I just bring counseling, and I found a lot of people are easier on counseling rather than struggling. Yeah, that's a reason. If I knew my client was in a house rather than an apartment, I'm easier using natural light. For natural light, I use whatever the house has. Then I also use a big, not a very big one, because I need to take to my client home. This is what I use. That size. It's a travel size diffuser. It has two sides, and there's also a translucent panel in the middle. So this is the panel in there. I can take it out, and I diffuse near the window of my client home, and diffuse the light. And also, I've got a bigger version of this panel in my studio because I use my studio natural light as well. And I also have sheer curtain. Right now it's nighttime. It's not going to show when you see, but I'm sure a lot of you guys, if you follow on my Instagram, you have seen my natural light portion in my studio already, so I'm not going to go through the details. Yeah, so in terms of lighting, this is what I normally use. Yeah, and then for my camera part, I use 5D Mark III, and my lens is 35mm Sigma Art 1.4. I've been asked a million times of this question. So here I am, this is my camera, and that's my lens. It stays on my camera body almost every day, every single session. And that thing here is the trigger. That's the trigger for my strobe, and that bottom bit is Godox, because it has a switch to turn on and off when I don't want this little thingy here. It controls, triggers my Einstein, but it doesn't have the on and off. So I use these both of the triggers to turn on and off. It's easier for me. Yeah, I've covered my camera, my lighting. What else in terms of gears? I don't think there's much. If any other gears I didn't cover, if you're interested in, feel free to ask me. Okay? Yeah, let's get into the beanbag workflow part. The reason why I turn off my studio light, I mean the lighting of in my studio, is because I only shoot with the one light. So at the moment, whilst I'm talking with you, my lighting is this one, Einstein, the modeling light. And I also want to show, when I pose the baby, the difference it makes if you have multiple light.
I see. Oh, that's good now.
Good. Yeah, because there's a delay. So if I had my ceiling light or the environment, say let's for instance this is daylight, daytime, when a lot of babies being photographed in my studio, obviously it would be during the day, and if my studio is filled up with natural light, and then I have my second lighting, which is the strobe, is next to me. The shadow is going to be too bright. I like, as you know, I like contrasty look. In my lighting style, there's quite dark shadow and there's strong highlights. So I like the contrasty look. There's no right or wrong. If you prefer the shadow not being so dark, you could lit up your environment, your studio, or you could introduce a second light. But to me, I like that contrasted look. I'd rather make my environment very dark, and my first light source, my only light source being my light source as the only light source. So that when the baby's being lit up, the highlight is bright enough and the shadow is dark enough. Make sense? Okay, I want to talk about what I usually use with my beanbag when I start to pose baby. Okay, can I get that stretchy rug? Right now I'm in front of my mother bean. It's from the Orange and Marshmallow block. That mother bean down there, and there's another pad above. It's from Orange Marshmallow Blocks as well. That pad is washable, you can just put it into the washing machine. Yeah, and there's a few layers on top of my mother bean. I like this mother bean because it's large enough for me to shoot baby in my studio. But if I take to my client home, I obviously can't take this. I take the perfect posing from the nail. Thanks, Anel. Thanks, Z. Thanks, Graceland. I'm grateful that I'm a brand ambassador. I can use such a great prop. Maybe in the next episode or future episodes, I will talk about how I use the perfect posy to how I utilize the perfect posy to do most out of a session when you travel with. Right now I'm in my studio, so I may as well just use my big bean bag rather than a small one. Yeah. And the frame is from La Michelle. It's the right size for the mother bean. I also lift up the mother bean by about, I don't know if you can see, there's a foam pad underneath. Here we go. That's about 20 centimeters high. It lifts up my bean bag by 20 centimeters, so that I have enough height from my beanbag to the frame. Okay, cover it up. Usually when I pose the baby on my beanbag, I wouldn't sit on this stool because it's a little bit too high. I can't find a smaller chair here. That's alright. To start my workflow, my beanbag workflow, I usually start from the back pose. Whilst my baby is on my laps, I try to put the hands and legs on the baby's chest when she's, let's name her Sarah. I don't know why I like the name Sarah so much. Sarah right now, she's calm and she's settled.
I'm gently just rocking Sarah so that she knows we are in a comfortable environment. To pose the baby on her back, firstly we need to wrap the baby's arms. There's a couple of ways. There's another way I call this eggshell wrap, but I don't usually just start with eggshell wrap because it gets tricky. They startle very easily with eggshell wrap. This is the half wrap. Half wrap is you first wrap the baby's arms. It doesn't matter how you wrap it, but the thing is you need to wrap it quite tight with a stretchy wrap. Yeah. This fabric, it's called jersey wrap, jersey fabric. It's stretchy. It's very similar to what I showed last time, last episode, as a potato sack's first layer. The point is just to wrap the baby's arms, to keep the arms in place, like this. And then I would wrap around the bum. At this point of time, usually I would take the nappy away, because if you had the wrapping nappy down there, it just looks too bulky and it just doesn't look very clean. Can see, right? Okay. Carry on. With this piece of fabric, because it's quite long, it's around 1.8 meters long. You can run a few times around Sarah's body to finish the fabric, but I don't like doing that because it just makes the baby look too bulky and too much fabric around her just doesn't look too good, too flattering to me. Yeah, one or two rounds would be enough. Then for the rest of the fabric, usually I leave it as a tail, or you can just hide it behind the baby's back like this. Right now it's flat, the beanbag is flat. However, we need to lift up baby's head and baby's bum using two beans. Can you pass me the trolley, please? You see how my suit looks like right now. Even more props than I usually have in my photo shoot. Okay, anyways, my trolley is here. I've got this size, the bean, maybe a bean, a medium size, or maybe a large size, I don't know. But it's quite big. I put this underneath this pad, in between the mother bean and the top layer, the top pad. If you don't have this top layer, just put it underneath these fabrics. because if you put here, you will see the bean, and it just, it looks like you have something underneath. The more fabric you put on top, the smoother it will get. I've got three layers here. When I travel to my client home, I use their blankets. I ask for 4, 5, 6, as many blankets as they could provide me. I don't have to bring them with me when I travel to my client home. It's just because, you know, you bring the essentials. And these are the ones that my client can get if they all have in their home. So the first thing I put here is where the baby's head gonna go, and the second bean, another big size bean, I put here. So one here and one here. Similar size. If you can't find two exact same size, this one is a little bit smaller than the head bean. Head bean. And this is the bum bean. Okay. Bum bean, head bean. There's a small ditch here. Is it called ditch? Alright. I'm glad Sarah is so calm. She wouldn't usually stay calm for so long. So it's important, as you know, when you do a newborn session, get the beans ready before you place the baby down, because she's obviously not going to stay in pose for this long time. And then you put her down. When you put her down, the bum goes into the ditch and the head onto the bean here, the head bean here. When the bum bean is too further away, like right now, I would just push it towards her bum. See how at the moment her head is too low? It's because I used two same sized beans. I should have used another bigger bean for the head. Let's see if this one would raise up the head of just a tad. Yeah. The way how I put the bean is not this one. This one not on top of the other one. It's slightly on top, but not entirely, so that you don't have a very elevated surface on the head, just by lifting up the head about 50%. That's all. Alright, at the moment she's facing up toward the ceiling. What I need to do and what I look for is her face, the lighting on her face. See how she's only being lit up about this much on her forehead. I need to tilt her head. Tilt her head towards the light. Let's see where I placed my light. The light is facing towards me. I need the light to face towards the baby a bit more. Sorry, there's cables everywhere. And I use studio light. And cables. need to move my light towards me. If she's facing up the ceiling, obviously her face is going to be too dark. To get her to face towards me. And the lighting is 45 degrees. So light is this direction. And the baby is this direction. It makes a 45 degrees angle. And her bum, remember her bum was still, I didn't move her bum at all. The bum is still laid on top of the beanbag, straight towards the ceiling. Her legs are still towards the ceiling. And try to tilt her body a little bit towards that diagonal line. So when you shoot from this angle. Down toward the bum. So you end up having a very blurred background and a blurred body. I will take a test shot and show you the difference. Can I get my camera? Manual mode, I've been asked a lot of questions regarding my camera setting. It doesn't really matter so much as long as you're on manual mode and my f-stop is f2. Depending on the setups, usually on beanbag I'm in between f2 to f2.5. ISO 100, 200 per second shutter speed. Kevin is 5800. Let me do a quick test shot and see how the lighting looks. It's a bit too strong, just turn the light down a little bit. Have a look. Right now, see how her face is towards the ceiling. I don't like that. First of all, you're only seeing 2/3 of her face. I would prefer seeing the full face. It's just a little bit detail that I pay quite a lot of attention to. I try to tilt her face towards me. And shoot. Yeah. See the comparison. This one, you could hardly see the other eye. And this one, you could see both eyes. And remember when I said tilt her body toward that diagonal line. Because if you don't, if she's lying like this, and her body was just like a straight position body pose. When I take a shot. See, the first thing comes into your eye is her body. How big that body looks. But if you tilt her body towards the diagonal line, you will see her body would look blurred and look small. It was before and it was after. I mean, the wrong one and the right one. Okay. And you could also shoot from above in this pose. But I don't usually do that. The shots I would do for this particular pose is one further away as a establishing shot and coming a bit closer, a couple of close ups. If you want, you can take from above, further away, medium, close up, these three. And if it was a girl, you put a hairband, without hairband, put a bonnet, without bonnet, and take everything away. Just shoot with nothing, no accessories. There's one thing I need to point out in regarding to the angle itself is that when you shoot, let me grab the webcam. When you shoot, I shoot from here. That's my camera angle. My camera angle goes here. And I tilt my camera towards this 45 degrees angle. I don't like shooting this way because it looks like the baby is falling down or lying. I would rather tilt my camera to 45 degrees so that the baby looks like leaning on the beanbag. Okay? And close up. Also, if you are shooting, obviously you're not going to shoot from below, you're shooting above your nostril. If you were shooting this way, the body looks too big. But if you just come a little bit towards her forehead and shoot down, your baby's body will look smaller and it's more flattering. Okay. Then move on from this pose to the next one. The next pose I generally do is I just take away all the fabric. If the baby is not waking up, if she's still cooperating. By just pulling the fabric out. You could also do this actual wrap. Pull the fabric out, keep her arms in place obviously, and just pull the fabric out on her body. You don't have to take the fabric away, just wrap around the baby's body and leave the fabric behind her. And take the arms out. You could put one hand underneath her face and the other hand on her chest. Or you could put underneath her head as well. Just another relaxing look. Similar angle as I did before, you shoot one from here. I would shoot one from above. Demonstration purpose, I'm going to shoot another one from above. Right now, remember her head and her body is still making that V shape. I never place the baby straight like a post like this. Always tilt the baby's head. Just give a relaxing look. I'm gonna shoot one from above. Remember, we still have that YouTube live going on. That's from above. Okay. All right. If the baby's still calm, I would take all the fabric, just take the fabric down. Instead of clamping them onto the beanbag frame, I take them down and move my lighting towards the back to shoot a backlit style. But at the moment, because there's a lot of cables going on, I'm not going to move it until the end. I will show the backlit lighting style towards the end. Right now all the cables are on the floor, makes it really hard to move. But that's not my every session, not my go-to lighting style. I like it because it's, I like the style, because I like the backlit style, but I don't shoot it all the time. Again, you shoot from above, from this way. So two angles. I usually would have my assistant hand on the baby's arms and legs, because with this particular wrap, the hands and legs are free. The arms and legs are free. The baby could startle very easily. And it's very challenging when they startle, they'll cry, and you'll probably finish your session here when they start crying. So hold the legs and arms until you click your shutter button. It's quite important. If you don't have an assistant, get parents to help you out. The startle may ruin everything. Okay, so move on from here. The back post is pretty much it. Variation from the first one to the second one is you could, again, take the headpiece off, put a bonnet on for boys, with or without a bonnet. If she's still awake, if she's still asleep, there's another one you could do, is that you could wrap your fabric around the baby's head. So it just looks like, Sarah looks like in one pose. It's called one. Just around the head for one layer. Don't wrap around too much, otherwise she looks like being trapped. And in this, you tuck, in this pose, you tuck in all the fabric underneath her. Remember to tilt her head towards me rather than bury her chin. You need to lift up her chin, tilt her face towards me. How small she looks right now. I'm gonna shoot from here. And another one from above. There we go. One from here, and the other one from above. Okay, so move on. The next pose is quite challenging. We are going to flip the baby over. They generally would cry and don't freak out if they cry. Super normal. But before doing, before flip her over on the beanbag, I flip her over on my chest. See how she's, right now she's on my chest. I'm using my left hand to support her neck, right hand to support her bum. She will wiggle and she will cry and she'll scream. She will make a big fight. But that's okay if you have both hands around her to secure her and to rock her. She would calm down gradually. However, if she doesn't, yeah, just pass on to mom, give her a bit milk and give her some comfort. Let's assume she's calmed down right now. For this pose, the back, the tummy pose, you could use your fabric, or you can use it, or you don't have to use it. The fabric could create some variation. You can use this stretchy one, or you could use the cheese cloth one. Can you pass me that cheese cloth fabric? How many we have? No, not this one. Choose what fabric I just gave you. This is a cheesecloth fabric. It has that creases. The same fabric that I used for my potato sack I taught last week. Let's put the fabric underneath her on my beanbag, on top of my beanbag. So this pose, I am going to transit into the chain on hand. Or bum up. Let's do bum up first. There's no particular order that I carry out for every single baby. As long as, you know, bum up. Or one or the other. Or you could do both if you think she's capable of doing both. Let's do the bum up first. with the bum up, I need one bean. Right now she's in my palm. Just give her a walk as long as she's settled, and I can fiddle the beans underneath. So with the beans, the beans, I have a big one, same as what I did before on for those back poses. One big bean here as a head bean, and a smaller bean. These two are very similar size, but a little bit smaller. A smaller bean as a bum bean. And still there's a bitch in between the beans. What was that about?
Nothing.
Okay. Lay my fabric on the living room. There's a couple of variations you could do. You could also put another pillow, a static pillow, on top of my beanbag. You could put a fur, a rabbit fur. It's all personal style, depending on your personal preference. At the moment, I'm using a cheesecloth underneath. How to do the bum up pose is I use the left hand, put the left hand, baby's left hand underneath her cheek. The other hand doesn't matter. And it's quite important how you hold the baby. So these four fingers hold at the back of the baby's neck, and your thumb holding underneath the baby's cheek with the hand underneath her cheek. So you are grabbing the baby's neck like this. That's the motion of your left hand. With the right hand, at the same time, you cross the baby's leg by tucking the right foot, the foot that's further away from you, underneath the knee. I don't know what they call this part here. So tuck in this foot underneath here. Don't do the other way around, because otherwise you'll end up having the knee poking out. This way you could see the toes of the right foot, and this foot, it doesn't matter if you see, you can see or not. So this is the way the baby has to be in your hands. Takes a bit of practice, because you need to know which finger goes to where, which toes goes to where. The only body part of the baby not in your hands is her right hand, the hand that's further away from you. So this hand, see how it's hanging down? But if you could just lift up the hand rather than having it hanging down like this. Obviously right now she's on your body. Have your chest to support her. Don't let her go like this. She'll jump and she'll fly away. Let's just put her on my chest. Okay? Slowly transit her arm to the beanbag. If her if you lose her hands or lose the legs, don't freak out. You could still adjust her position whilst she's on the beanbag. Okay, so here we go. Straight away, her bum has been lifted up. And now, see the hand here, the left hand, the hand that's closer to you is underneath her cheek, and the elbow is close to her knee. It looks very simple. Looks quite simple, but it's a little tricky when you have the real baby in your hand. The right hand, the hand that's further away from you, just put by the side. At the moment, you've got the cheesecloth here. What I usually do is I wrap around the baby's body. You could wrap the entire bum, and you could also show the bum. Just tuck in inside the baby's leg. The important thing is try to straighten the fabric around the baby's body. Wherever you can see around the baby's body, make sure the fabric is straightened nice and tight. I don't like seeing the fabric hanging too loose. It's, again, it's just personal details. I'm a very detailed person. I'm sure you guys all are. Yeah. And the fabric behind her, let's just make it look a bit more organic, rather than have the fabric being like this. It just looks like she's a superhero of some kind. Let's have the fabric closer to her, and it looks flowy, looks organic, looks natural. Just doesn't look too stiff, as long as the fabric is nice and flowy. That's all good. And tuck in where underneath her right side, just tuck it underneath. I'll grab my camera and take a shot. Lighting, I didn't change much. But you need to see 2/3 of her face being lit up. You don't want to have the light lit up the baby like this, because you can see all her face is being lit up. I just need 2/3 to here. Again, you could do a better way, a medium shot, a close-up, and one from the front, and one from above. I didn't change my camera setting. Still 2.2, F2.2, 200 per second shutter speed, ISO 100, 5800, Kelvin. and move on. Chin or hands is the next pose. You could chin or hands first and this bum up second, or you could do the other way around. Doesn't matter. See, right now, let me take a shot so I can show you later on in the group. Right now the beans underneath is one head and one bum. With the chin or hand, I need to take this one away, leave the head being underneath, and I need another towel. Can I get a towel, please? The receiving blanket, whatever you call it. Oh, by the way, variation from here is you can take the fabric away. Leave it on, take it away. Or you have the pillow here. If you have a pillow, take it away, put it on, change the headband, change the bonnet. There's all sorts of variation without waking up the baby. So the next chain on hands, I use another receiving blanket underneath the head pillow. I'm going to roll it up. Here. And take a photo. Okay, so I can show you later. Tilt her body towards the diagonal line a bit more. And the bean, it was before, the bean was on here. Now I need to move forward towards me because the baby is obviously gonna, the face is going to face towards me a bit more. Okay, so the bean, the surface that she's going to support her head needs to come forward towards me. It'll make sense when I move the baby. There's nothing back there. Push this bum part a bit down. Now bring the arms forward. Spread the arms out. Spread them apart. A lot of photographers make mistakes when they do chin on hand is they get the arms to go across like this, like too much. You need to spread the arms out quite a bit more further apart. Just have the hands on top of the other and put the hands down underneath the chin rather than having the arms around and the head on the arms. So you need to put the chin on the hands and only seeing three, four fingers, both hands. Flat fingers if possible. Don't get the hands, don't have your fingers curled up like this. Straighten, flatten the fingers. Sarah doesn't have fingers, which is good, makes me easier. But the real baby has fingers. It's very important, I can't stress too much about the fingers. The same as potato sack and all my other wrapped poses. You need to look out your fingers position and how the fingers look. Yeah. So with regards to the legs, just pull the legs apart. Spread the legs apart. If she's resisting, she would automatically take the arms close to her body. We need to relax her down by patting her, give her a rock. If she's crying, give her a rock, give her a pat, just try to settle her down before we actually perfect the pose. Because if she's unsettled, you are trying to fix the pose and you'll get very frustrated. She wouldn't let you. When she's relaxed, pull her arms further. So the arms right now are on top of my beam, and there's this receiving tower underneath as well. See? That fabric, leave it behind her. Okay, I'm gonna take a shot. And we'll see, I'll show you how the pattern looks like underneath. Take a shot. My camera angle is quite high, we all know. You can never shoot from those below, not above nostril. Okay, I'll show this picture in the group later on. Alrighty. Again, the variations from his take the bonnet away, with the bonnet, without the bonnet, with the fabric, without the fabric. Further away, medium, close up, and another one is from above. From above, further away, close up, all these three variations. Okay. So next I'll show you what it looks like underneath. Sorry Sarah, I'll have to bury you. There we go. Okay, so what's underneath is this towel. It's rolled up. So it gives a longer surface for the baby to rest her albums on. And the chin has to come forward. So the chin has to go this. If the baby is not cooperating, if she's unsettled, when you move her, she would pull her chin in. So once she's settled, try to relax her and gently pull her chin out. There we go. I know being bad gets very cheeky and challenging. And I don't do all these poses with every single baby. At some point, they will cry. They'll start to cry, or maybe they will mess up your beanbag. And my beanbag poses ends from here. So don't get too carried away. With everything underneath. All right, about it for my go-to beanbag poses. After you've done all these, how many I've done now? I think I've done three or four poses. After all these three or four poses, you'll have at least about 20 images for the parents. 20 plus the prop poses that you are providing. I provide another three prop poses. So plus this beanbag, plus another three, plus the parents' shots. Easily you can reach your pictures by 40, 50. That's way too much. I usually stick my picture gallery around 35 to 40. This is just a beanbag. If you have spent quite a long time on the beanbag, reduce your other time. Reduce your other prop time. And if you still have time, or if the baby is still cooperating, if it takes fancy of you, feel free to experiment the froggy pose, which is what I'm going to show you. Personally, I am not a big fan of froggy. It just freaks me out. Because I don't think the baby's doing froggy in mommy's tummy. And I don't want to force baby. If she's not cooperating with me, I give up. I try to reinforce the importance of let the baby to lead the session rather than you lead the baby. Not because that the mom is requesting this the froggy pose, so you have to do that. It's just because I think from the workflow point of view, and you want to move it as smoothly as possible, and you could also have some build up some confidence as well. Sometimes it's not your control if the baby's not cooperating, and it's nothing wrong with you. Don't get too frustrated if you can't make this pose, this particular pose, right. To me, froggy is just not my go-to pose. Okay, but I will show you how I do the froggy. Where's my beam? Oh, here it is. I'm getting done. Same thing with the beam. I still use this large beam underneath here, where her arms are. And this receiving towel still stays here at one end of the beam. Okay, the baby didn't move much, but I need to get the baby's legs forward. Sometimes I would just hold the baby up, sit her up, have the legs, just cross the legs in front of her tummy, like a normal sit-up position. How you would sit up the baby. They would sit up like this, right? And then you have the hands here underneath the chin. Close the gap in between the wrist. Is that called wrist? Close the wrist here. And use just two fingers of one hand. Put underneath here. If she cries, if she's trying to pull the hands off, put her down. Give her a pad. Slowly pull one hand down. And the other hand closer to the other hand. And close the wrist. And sit her up. She would again move the elbows away. Once she's settled, pull the elbows forward towards you. Now, this pose, I need an assistant. I need the assistant to pull the legs towards her elbow, because you may end up having the toes underneath her tummy. You're not seeing the toes. I need to see the toes. So I need the assistant to pull the toes out. This is a pose I can't do it by myself, either with the help from mom or from the assistant. I prefer to use my assistant rather than the parents, because they just don't know what they are doing. Pull the toes forward wherever you can see. Don't bury their toes. Now, chin, remember the chin, don't bury the chin, lift it up and put underneath her hands, and use just one hand, your two fingers to close the wrist. Spread apart the elbow, don't get the elbow to get too close, spread them apart, then we should be ready to shoot. It's always a composite shot. One from here, and the other one I have to get my assistant. Do you want to come here? Head. So just support the head by grabbing. See, my assistant doesn't know what he has to do, not to mention the parents. Grab the head and slowly let go my fingers. Keep where you are, take your hand away, and put your hand on. Keep the camera position so it's easier to do the composite afterwards. These are the two shots you need to do. Okay, then another shot is from the side. Same thing, one holding the head and the other one holding the wrist. That's about it. Alrighty. So today I've demonstrated about four or five poses. Oh, again, the next one is the backlit lighting. Can I get the camera away? When you're doing your backlit, I need to remove everything from the beanbag, from the beanbag frame. Just put the fabric down. Baby do whatever she wants. Baby Sarah can sleep. Now see, I'm moving my lighting from here. Do you want to hold that camera so that they can see how I'm moving my light? I need to move the lights to the back.
stepping on my own cable. Okay. This backlit lighting style is only for back poses, not the chin on hands, not the bum up poses, just the back pose. Now I need to take the beans, everything underneath. I'm going to take them out. Where I'm going to put them, the bean, the large bean, and the medium bean. This one is big. This big bean and the medium bean, one underneath the head, and the other one underneath the bum. So the head bean and the bum bean. Again, same thing as what I did at the back post early on. Let's just put here, it's easier to see. Okay, still a V shape. And then her body is still a V shape. Because I feel that her face is being too dark, or rotate her towards my light. I don't want to take away all the fabrics. Do you want to take that? On her chest. There we go. Okay. I'll show you how I post her. I will shoot from here, from above, and another angle is shooting from the side, from the dark side towards the light. I'll grab my camera and take some photos. Okay, this is about it. In terms of fabrics, I need to recommend some fabrics for you guys. Can I get that fabric? And there's a leather wrap, the stretchy wrap, and there's a knit wrap. Yeah, no, the other one.
Okay, so this is the cheese, sorry, this is the fabric I used with my last week, last episode potato sack fabric as the internal fabric. I use it as well on my beanbag clothes to wrap the baby. Mostly it's stretch, because it's stretchy and it's flowy as well, you could use either way, as to restrict the baby's movement, or you could use it as an aesthetic decoration on the beanbag. For this one, the cheesecloth, which is what I use as a decorative wrap, I don't usually use to wrap to restrict baby, because it's very stretchy this way, but it's not very stretchy that way. I can use it, as you have seen, I can use it for the bum up pose, the chin on hand, the back, the tummy pose, but not so much for those back poses. You could use it, but you'll find it's very hard to restrict the hands and the arms, and they will break. They will break out. These are the two main fabrics that I use for 99% of my sessions and for my 99% of my babies and those poses as well. As well as the set of the prop poses. That is a 1%. This is called the knit wrap, the knit fabric. Again, it's not very stretchy this way. It's stretchy this way. I use it only because I don't have this particular color, or there's a type I need to use some kind of knit fabric, the knit texture, to match the styling. Let's say, for instance, the potato sack, or using a matching bonnet, a matching knit bonnet, I use this one. Yeah, so this is about it. Three different types of fabrics I use during my photo shoot. I recommend you get one of these, at least this type, just to build up your collection first. And then you go to the cheesecloth because it's decorative. And this is yes or no. You don't have to have. So fabric-wise, this thing is a must-have. I recommend you go to check out my own prop shop. It's called Swan Props. You can find the fabrics that I used. The white one. The cream one, there's a couple of colors that I use a lot. I use throughout my entire sessions as an internal lab for the past 2 years. The past 2 or 3 years, I've been kept using that type of fabric. It's about $15. I can't recommend more enough. That is so good. I've used a lot of other cheesecloths, which is not so good, and I end up doubting myself and questioning my own wrapping technique until I found this. It's just the best fabric that I've ever used. Of course, I have used some other fabric from other vendors, but yeah, just this is the best as far as I have. Okay, then the cheesecloth, again, I have in my prop shop as well. Not because I'm selling it, I'm recommending to you. It's because I have used them, and I found they are the best ones. So I recommend to you guys stop wasting money on other experiments and just get the one that is right for you. And right for me, it would be right for you as well if you don't know what you are going to pick. Just my recommendation. That knit fabric is not what I usually recommend for starting out a photographer. I spend a lot of money on these. They are very expensive. I think it's about 40, 50 bucks each per piece because it's handmade, stitch by stitch. Obviously it's expensive. But if you want, I have them all tagged on my Instagram posts. You can find out. But the last time I used it was probably a few months back. You can always email me to ask or leave a message on Facebook to ask where I get it from. Okay? Now, questions. Is there any questions you need to ask? I'm just gonna come to my computer and see what questions you have, and then we can turn the lights on. Don't worry about that. It's live for 98 minutes. We've been live for 98 minutes now. Okay. Give me a sec. Yilan, 这个帮我拿一下。我来拉这个，你来拉手机。Okay. How do I finish this? Okay, we are finished on our Instagram live here. Let me just cross that. Stop streaming.